What is up? Matthew DeMoe here with some fresh EDM news. Yesterday, Insomniac Events announced the brand new lineup for EDC Las Vegas 2018, which means we can officially start deciding between what I call the EDM Festival Big Three, those being Tomorrowland, Ultra, and EDC. So we can officially start deciding between the different festivals, which ones have the best lineup, which ones are the best lineup for you. So let's just go over what the EDC lineup has in store for us this year. EDC obviously is going to have some of the big festival headliners, a lot of crowd favorites such as Martin Garrix, Tiesto, Diplo, Zedd, and Eric Prydz.
Bro, what about Dimitri Vegas and Like Mike?
Those guys as well. And then on top of that, you have the EDC newcomers, first timers, which include Moxie, Yuki, Gigi McGree, Weathen, and Parker. So congratulations to them. I hope they have great sets. I hope you guys enjoy them too if you're going. If you want to know if your favorite artist is going to EDC, I'm going to leave the lineup in the description below. And what you can do is you can press Control F on your keyboard and you can manually search for that must-see artist that kind of has to be there for if you want to go. So that's the good news. A very stacked lineup. A lot of good, solid returning players as well to the game. However, some big names aren't going to quite make it this year. For example, there's going to be no DJ Snake at EDC compared to Ultra and Tomorrowland. Same goes with Axwell and Grosso, which I think they're only playing Tomorrowland. I don't know if they're playing Ultra. Dylan France is going to be sitting out because he's in album tour mode probably. Same goes with Arl Grime. Also, Ghastly and Quix aren't going to be there, unlike last year, which I thought were two of the cool, fresher, very fun acts to see. And then I can even list a couple more. Mr. Carmack, Alice in Wonderland, Oliver Heldens, Boombox Cartel. And last but not least, DJ Khaled. Although DJ Khaled's going to be sitting out, there is going to be a hip-hop portion of the lineup, which will consist of Mike Will Made It and DJ Mustard, who I think are going to do a better job of actually bringing out some actual talent to perform and actually put on a good show that could keep up with the pace and energy of a crazy festival like EDC. As far as special appearances and back-to-back sets that I'm looking forward to, I'm definitely looking forward to the Virtual Self set. I'm really interested to see how the energy and the vibe plays out in this set because his Brooklyn show, in my opinion, out of a two-hour set, he might have had the audience hooked for the first 20 minutes and then 10 minutes towards the end. So I'm hoping that Porter Robinson doesn't lose the crowd because that's one of the reasons I'm a huge fan of Porter Robinson's DJ sets is when he's behind the decks, the crowd is always really into it. He always puts in great shows. So this might be the first time ever that I'm a little iffy on whether Porter Robinson can pull it off, especially in a big, big festival crowd like EDC. The back-to-back set that I'm looking most forward to this year is the collective known as The Benches, which consists of four super producers, those being Kazo, OK, Yultron, and .com. If you're not really familiar with .com, he also plays under a much more known alias, that being Marshmello. I'm curious in the set if .com's going to be playing any new music, because we don't get to see a lot of .com sets often. Then also, on top of that, Kazo, OK, and Yultron just have great synergy, but enough differentiating characteristics that I think this is going to be a crazy set. Going to be a lot of interesting songs on it. Then another back-to-back set I'm looking forward to, Kill the Noise and 12th Planet. Another great synergy, two veteran producers. They've done many EDCs, and I'm happy that they're finally doing a back-to-back set together. Then one last point, the Pendulum DJ set is not Knife Party. Don't go to the Pendulum DJ set expecting Centipede or Destroying with Lasers. At best, you're going to get Ghosts and Stuff. And then, of course, Pendulum Music. When it's all said and done, unless your absolute must-see favorite artists are playing Ultra or Tomorrowland rather than EDC, I think EDC is still jam-packed with so many great acts. EDC really did cover all the bases and still one of the best lineups in the world. Who didn't make the lineup that you're desperately hoping would be on the roster? Who are you looking forward to see if you're going? If you like the video, remember to like and subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.